To log in or create an account, go to connect.trimble.com and click sign in the top right. Here, you can type in your credentials, create a new account with signing in with Google, or click create an account and fill in your information here. Then, once you click create an account, you'll get a confirmation email and you can log in. Once you're logged in, you can click the menu button in the top right corner of Trimble Connect. Here, you can download Trimble Connect Desktop or for Windows and the Trimble Connect plugin for Revit, which only goes up to Revit 2019 at this time. And you can buy Trimble Connect for mixed reality. Here, you can buy any form of Trimble Connect: personal, business, business monthly, business annual, business premium, the project or enterprise versions, and finally, Trimble Connect for mixed reality monthly and annual. And these include all of the business premium features. Then you can click Buy Now. And you'll see the Trimble Connect for Mixed Reality added to your cart. Once added, you can change the number of licenses or users. You can change if you'd like an account assigned to you or not. You can enter a promo code if you have one and then check out. And here you'll just confirm and continue. And then you'll type in your credit card information. To manage your accounts, you can click in the person on the top right corner of connect.trimble.com and click manage. And here you'll be redirected to our account management page, and you can just go to the members option. Here you'll be shown how many available seats there are, and if you're the admin, you can add or remove people. So once that's all processed, this is how you create a new project. You just click New in the top right corner of connect.trimble.com after logging in. Then you can give your project a name, select a location and an ownership for the project, and submit. Now my new project is getting set up. Alrighty, here we can see we can drag and drop into this area to create, or we can click on any of these buttons to perform these actions. So we'll bring in this model, wait for that to upload. Alrighty, the upload is complete. Now another way to add files is clicking Add and Upload Files. Then you can browse your computer and go through your folders, or you can click and drag your models into the click and drag spot, and we'll wait for those to upload. Great. And now, if you want to do anything with these models, you can select the little box next to them. And now we can download or delete these models. If you download them from the cloud, you can access them offline. And now we'll go into Trimble Connect Desktop and upload a model that way. Alrighty, here we'll go back into our example project. Wait for our models to load and click Upload Model. And select that model that we just deleted to get it back in this folder. And we'll see it upload successfully here on desktop. And now we'll go back to Trimble Connect Web. And just jump out or jump back in or refresh. And now we'll see that third model back in this folder. It does take a little bit longer to process when it's transmitted that way onto web. So we'll just wait a second. We can see it's in progress and loading while the other model's already there. Alrighty, now we have everything loaded up. Here, you can change the position of your model. For example, if it comes in with an elevation or you want to change it in a specific direction, now we'll raise the elevation using this slot here at the bottom, and you can see that model jump back up. And then to bring it back down, we'll change that back to the negative elevation. You can see the value up there at the top under position X. And now the models are back to their original place. Open the folder that you'd like to create the sequence in. Then open the models that you'd like to include in the sequence in the 3D view. And now to begin your sequence, select the sequence button over here on the right-hand taskbar. And to start step one, just click add step. And now you're ready to add objects. So to add objects in each step, you can either select each object and click add objects, Or you can hold shift and select multiple objects to add them simultaneously. Or if you'd like to access the different models open or the different layers within the models, you can move the sequence bar. You will get a pop-up. It will say, no, we do not want to exit without saving. Now we can move our sequence bar over to the other side and open up our model bar. Here we can see the different models and layers we have open. This is very helpful if you're creating a sequence with multiple models, or if you'd like each model to be a step within the sequence. You can just turn off the ladder model, hold shift, and select the whole model to make it step one, and then turn off that model and turn on the other to make that one step two. In this demo, I'll be going through and working with the different layers within this model. This helps make sure you don't miss any small bolts or any little details in each step. So first, I'm going to turn off all the layers and turn on the two that are in my first step. Then I'll hold shift and select it all. Add the objects and type my instructions. Then I'll add step two. And in this case, I'm going to turn on all the layers because there's a lot of different ones in the framework, and then turn off the ones in previous steps or future steps. Now I'll hold shift and select all of these objects. Click add objects and type my instructions. And then I will add step three sequence and just turn on the piping and the plumbing that I want in step three. Hold shift and select all of the pipes and details. Add objects, make it and type my instructions. So now my sequence is ready to go. I've got all of my details in each step and I'm ready to save. Then you'll see our saved sequence load up here. It'll be sequence six in a minute when it's ready. This is in our views browser. So to access the sequences, you can click on the views option over here. This is because each step of the sequence is technically a view of the model. So that's where you access those. And then if you right click on the sequence, you can remove it from the folder, share it with anyone who you'd like to have it within the project, or edit the sequence, which will take you back to that editor. We do suggest that if you edit the sequence after sharing, that you share it again so that all of those updates are processed and the user receives an email that says they've had a model shared with them. If you want to access different views or sequences that have been shared with you, you can just click this drop-down of own views and change it to shared with me to see any models that have been shared with you. And if you would like to watch your sequence in Trimble Connect Desktop, just select the sequence and select this play button here. This will play your sequence step-by-step with your instructions here in the bottom left corner. Connect mobile app, you can go to the Play Store or the App Store on an iOS, search for Trimble Connect, pick the app, and click install. And once the app is finished installing, we'll click open. And we will allow Trimble Connect access, accept the terms, and sign in to our TID. And I will proceed with North America because that's where most of my projects are and I'm located. And I just want to point out here, you can click HoloLens Companion to open up a QR code to scan and log in for Trimble Connect for HoloLens. Now you can see all of your projects, you can change your server location or filter your projects in a different way. To download Trimble Connect for HoloLens, you go to the Microsoft Store on your HoloLens. Then search in the top right. You can just start typing Trimble and you'll see Trimble Connect come up. Alrighty, there it is. Now we'll click install. And you may or may not be asked to enter your Microsoft account information here. And click install now that I entered my information. Wait for the app to download. Okay, now we can launch the app. When Trimble Connect first downloads, you'll have to grant it access and permissions to your eye tracker and to your camera and to your microphone. And click continue, and now you're ready to log in.